Last time we saw you guys, we were at Abbey Road, I do believe. Has life got any better since then? It's like 3 weeks ago.
I mean, that was the highlight of our life so far. So it's just been a steep downhill since then. But no, joking aside, that was a really fun night to be in Abbey Road, somewhere so special. And since then, we've been on the road. We've started a tour around Northern Europe. And
you got to plug in your guitar amps this time.
We did, exactly. Make some real noise, like a real rock band. We played in Cologne last night, and we're off to Helsinki tomorrow. So
fairly varied then, goodness me.
Fairly varied, but it's been fun.
It's been great. It's when you record a new album, you're kind of like dogs in the traps, ready to go, and we're finally been allowed out and unleash our new album in the world, so it's been great.
And a huge amount of tracks on that double album. How many cock-ups have there been so far?
Really? Do you know what? We've been okay so far.
We rehearsed a little bit, you know, we made sure that we could play them before we took them to the stage. Yeah.
Well, you seem very, very tight, as I think I mentioned on the evening at Abbey Road. You're going up against the Rolling Stones, a best British band. That's fairly epic, isn't it?
Yay!
Wouldn't see them in Abbey Road. Well, you would, but they'd be recording their album.
That's pretty scary when you put it like that. We don't really see it like a competition, like the way that you've put it there.
I call it a knife fight.
Okay. I don't want to get into a knife fight with Ronnie.
I mean,
Wood.
You know, our dad had Stones records, you know, and so to be mentioned in the same breath as them is really quite incredible, you know. Like I said, we're here to have fun, but when you start thinking about it, it is something that kind of you have to pinch yourself a little bit.
A little bit scary. What do you think sort of separates a good British band from a band from anywhere else in the world?
It's kind of funny because we grew up listening to mostly American music, and it did have some influence on our sound. I think there are people out there, Anglophiles, that just love British music, and maybe it's quite hard to put your finger on exactly what it is that makes them British, you know. I think perhaps those little quirks that the Brits have, you know.
I don't think Brits take themselves too seriously. I think they take the music seriously, but they don't take themselves seriously, whereas maybe bands from across the pond take themselves a little bit too seriously sometimes.
And perhaps our house is a little bit more modest, maybe.
Yes, we'll take that. Not mine, though. Yeah. I live in a huge...
massive swimming pool.
I live in a huge fucking house, man.
There's a Rolls Royce in the swimming pool as well. Goodness me. It's more swimming pool. It's more Rolls Royce than swimming pool, isn't it, really?
It's a car wash.
I want a car wash, basically. Guys, is this kind of why you do it? Is it all about the baubles, picking up the odd award every now and again?
Not really. I mean, this is a really nice thing to come to, and if we ever do win awards in the past, it's really nice, you know, and it's nice to be tip of the hat, and it's nice when the fans vote for something and you get an accolade, but it's not why you do it, you know. We do it for our souls and for our sanity. That's why we do it.
Would you be good at anything else, do you know?
Don't think so, no.
Well, on that note, get in there and eat some dinner. Fellas, thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you, man. Cheers.